So yun lang naman. And then also one of the reason that I invited you is to actually also ask you about the Ateneo NBA experience. Kasi makwento ko lang ha, parang this year kasi parang nagkaroon ako ng phase na parang gusto ko mag-MBA. Mm-hmm. Pero right now parang hindi ko na muna siya itutuloy. But I did shop around sa 4 major schools. Okay. And then umaten pa nga din ako yung sa ano eh. Ano tawag din yung sa Ateneo MBA yung ano nila? Yung parang... yung may guest speaker sila.
Yes. Okay.
Ayan. So, sige, we'll get to the details of it in a bit. So, actually, curious lang ako is, I'm hoping that you can share like your journey sa... ito muna. Share mo yung journey mo about your MBA. Tapos, in case man may manood sa clip na interested mag-MBA, does it make sense for me, mga ganyan. Parang answer some basic questions. Siguro kung nag-aalangan sila or what's in it for the person who's planning to take it. Ganun lang.
Sure. No problem. So, basics is MBA or Master's in Business Administration. Master's degree ng Ateneo de Manila University. It's now most people mas familiar sa Ateneo yung sa campus sa Katipunan Avenue in Quezon City. Can't really miss it. Katabi ng UP. Mahaba-haba ng Katipunan Avenue. But yung MBA or to be specific, the Graduate School of Business, yung location niya is actually in Makati, in the Rockwell Center. The same building as the School of Law. Kumbaga, let's say, 4 floors yung entire building, 2 floors sa amin, 2 floors sa law school. And essentially, pang independent part ng Ateneo. So, not exactly a straight, let's say, transfer from grade school to high school or college. You need to apply for the Graduate School of Business or as we call it, AGSB for the MBA. Now, AGSB has multiple MBA courses. We've got the MBA standard, your normal master's degree course. Meron master's degree for people who are also taking law. And there's a special course na Regis tawag, R-E-G-I-S. Tie up to with Regis University in the U.S. It's essentially I want to say it's pang, di naman siguro honors course, but pang sped up na MBA. Because ang MBA, usually, if you're part-time, as in, nagtatabaw ka pa, and you're taking your MBA, it usually takes about 3 to 4 years. But ang MBA Regis, you can actually do that in as little as 2 or 1 kung talagang super tiyaga mo talaga.
Mm-hmm.
I took the MBA standard course. So it took me to go working at the same time sa Dell about 4 years. May mga subjects kami. We call them courses. At the start, parang college, you have your parang core courses. You start with things like statistics, accounting, eventually mag-branch out na yun. We even have courses called, may course nga na called ethics eh, like corporate ethics, what and what not to do. And there are also electives. Like, may nakuha kong elective na for online business. And there's another elective na global marketing yung tawag. Well, na mag-reach out ka with other companies. some of the global marketing classes nag-travel nga abroad. Like I know a class na pumunta pang Korea to as a, essentially a field trip.
Wow.
I know. And ano pa ba sa atin eh? So let's say you take each course will take about 3 units. So depende talaga sa iyo how much you want to take in one trimester, kasi trimester ang atin eh when it comes to MBA. You can take as little as 3, you can do 6. Kung malakas ka talaga, you can do 9 or even 12. So 4 subjects in one trimester. And it's really designed for people who are already working. So if it's a weekday, your courses will start at around 6 p.m. And it can be 1.5 hours, pwedeng 3 hours. And then pag Saturday, full day na yon. Morning until night. Doon talaga yung majority of courses. And ibang courses you'll see are your classic business courses. Yung na-mention ka na marketing kanina. You'll also have things like operations and a course called managerial science, MANSAI. Essentially, gagamitin mo math to go through problems. Even halos ka-level na ng calculus eh. And at the very, very end of the MBA journey, you'll be asked to make a thesis. And let's say sa college, diba, sanay tayo sa ibang mga group thesis, group project at the end of the year, right? Sa fourth year. In Ateneo, you're expected to do it alone. All alone. Siyempre, of course, papatulong ka along the way, papatulong ka sa professor on how to do it, but it's going to be only your name sa thesis. And these thesis can range, sabihin natin, from 70 to like 150 pages long. Not including mga table of contents or appendices. And you'll be expected na i-defend mo against a panel. Usually, mga professors yun. Like, 2 to 3 professors. And if you successfully defend it, well, congratulations, you're an MBA. Tapos yung graduation is usually around August of every year, which is held doon sa Katipunan campus. And some companies, ang gusto nila, ang ginagawa nila is sila nagbabayad for the students. So, yung sagot nila yung tuition. And the tuition is pretty high. I want to say halos 2,000 to 3,000 per unit. So isang course would be like 6,000 to 7,000 pesos agad.
And actually, for this, or at least prices are subject to change asterisk.
Yep.
But syempre, heads up lang. Pero for this current school year kasi, hindi na sila per unit ang
okay,
by subject na. So yeah, the cost per subject is around 18,000 plus.
Wow. Yeah.
Per subject.
So kinumbay na talaga nila.
Tapos parang maximum I think ata 2 or 3, I forgot na.
Yeah.
Tapos anything in exceeds of 2 or 3, kailangan humingi ka ng permission from the dean para kung anong student affairs ba yun, whatever,
yep,
para ma-allow ka mag-take ng more classes, especially kapag yung MBA standard. Kasi nga, yep, diba yun yung pang part-time. Ayun, nahanap ko na umattend ako nung online open house nung April.
Mm.
Actually, even got the acceptance letter.
Okay.
Kaso nga lang, nung panahon na yun, masyadong gipit na to enroll.
Yes.
When I said gipit to enroll, I meant is yung time. Parang nung mag-enroll sana ako noon, wala nang slot. Puro ubus na.
Yes. And yung
mabilis maubos yung yung classes. Yun yung nakapansin ko. Yes. Parang yung tapos matitras yung mga latak. And then I was planning to, tapos something happened, yun. So I'm not pursuing MBA muna for the time being, but I was really, really interested nung first two quarters of the year, or at least nung first quarter of the year. So medyo dumaan ako sa process. So thanks for that. So by the way, let me ask some questions. So parang,
sure.
Kasi ako nung prospective student ako, what can you say is the Ateneo advantage? Parang in your words, as an, parang tingin ko true blue Ateneoan ka, no? Like from high school or elementary?
Yeah, parang ganun from grade school. So,
like you're the second person I know.
Magaling ni Ryan.
So, what do you think is the advantage parang of going, taking MBA at Ateneo, parang ganon? Why not AIM? Kasi ang benta ng AIM is sila daw ang preferred ng mga executives. Ganun.
Yes. Siguro, I think lalabas yung medyo bias ko dito. Is
that's okay.
Yung Ateneo is known for the Jesuit education style. As siguro for more of the listeners or the viewers, if not, kung di sila familiar sa Catholic faith, may mga different orders yun. The Dominicans, the Franciscans, and Jesuits are part of that. And ang Jesuits, back in the day, sila yung tinas na for education. So, ang part of the Jesuit education technique or style is to be not just pure memorization, but also to understand the material. Ang sinabi nga na nung panahon nga ni Rizal dati was sapientia et eloquentia. It's not enough na magaling ka magbasa or mag-aral. You also have to be able to express yourself, whether to words or sa written. So whatever you come bring in, it also has to go out. So hindi lang basta memorize ka na numbers, dates, facts and figures, kailangan mo i-explain to anyone else. Another thing is, at least sa Ateneo, is kahit pa paano, even though it's technically a business school, they also put a little faith, a little theology dun sa, in some classes, especially sa ethics, because they want to bring out na, yes, you're in business school, yes, you want to be, is it eventually go higher, climb the corporate ladder, make more some money, but tuturuan ka din ng Ateneo to be ethical, to be mindful of your choices when you make decisions, whether you're simple supervisor, manager lang, or all the way to, let's say, VP, or even yung mga CEO, CFO. Make the correct choices for the business, not just because you want to put a couple of zeros after your sueldo, but you're also doing the best thing, not just for yourself, but for the company and for society at large.
I thought nakamute ako. So, thanks for that, Ryan. So, another question naman. So, I'm not, for example, quotation mark ko na lang to. So, hindi pa naman ako manager or an executive. Will an MBA make sense for me?
Well, it depends. Ang suggestion ko for people who want to pursue the MBA is for people na who want to get more out of their career. There might be people na okay lang na normal office job, 8 to 5, just do a couple of spreadsheets and then log out at the end of the day, that's fine. But if you're going to an MBA kasi gusto mo matuto talaga about the ins and outs of the business, the what, the why, the how. You want to know ano yung things that make a business run. I want to see what the things that one makes the business prosper, and not just for the managers but for the employees as well. So ang MBA, ang suggestion ko is not just for people who want to put a line item dun sa resume nila na, uy, kung lagay ko masters, baka tataas yung sweldo ko ng 20,000 a month. No. But it's also because you want to show na seryoso ka. You want to make things, you want to make the things better for the company you'll be you're working with and potentially working with in the future.
Okay. What? How about you, John or Joms, if you're there na?
I'm here.
Okay, so ano ko muna sa inyo? I-round robin muna natin yung mga questions nyo about MBA and Ateneo in general. So John, anything you would like to ask Ryan about the Ateneo MBA program?
So ngayon ko lang alam na mayroon pala standard, tapos may na-mention about 3Gs.
Yes.
So different ba yung ano nun? Yung mas higher ba yung fee or anong difference niya? In general na lang.
For more, essentially it's nagbabayad ka for an accelerated program. So yes, mas mahal siya. So sabi nga ni says na just na let's say 18,000 for your subject. Ang Regis will be higher, baka 25 or even 30,000 a subject. But you'll be graduating faster. So kung nag-start ka ngayon, you could actually be marching for graduation by in 2 years or even next year. Talagang finish mo. And there are other MBA programs like na-mention kanina for lawyers who also want to be MBA. There are also MBA programs for, let's say, doctors. Kasi Ateneo also has a medical program. Yung sa medical city sa dun sa Ortigas. Sa Rock. Yeah, that Rockwell, the other Rockwell. Exactly. So, mga doctors na mag-MBA, ito yung magiging, let's say, owners ng hospital or at least people that would make decisions for yung operations, the upkeep, the financial health of their hospitals. Any recommendation na MBA for them?
Cool.
So,
mas less yung challenge dun sa standard? Kasi mas tagal kang kukunin mo yung course, di ba?
If anything, may most of the subjects pareho sa MBA standard. But may mga certain subjects na tailored talaga sa law or sa medicine or even, if I remember right, dati, there's even for government service. So may certain subjects, whether they're electives or dun sa course mismo, specific for them.
Okay. Thanks, Ryan.
Yeah. And usually yung mga ganun, let's say government, legal, or medicine, sometimes yung overall business na yung nag-recommend or nag-bayad sa kanila to take this MBA, the special MBAs, para mas matututo sila in the future.
Okay. How about you, Joma? Any questions to Ryan regarding Ateneo MBA?
None, actually. Nasagot naman na yung mga questions ko kanina nung nag-start pa lang, inabutan ko. Sagot din naman along the way. So it's very good. Very good. It's a good opportunity.
Okay. Thank you so much, Ryan, for sharing your Ateneo MBA experience. So, pupunta na kami sa regular part of the program.
Sir?
Okay, so...
Teka, kita niyo, may webcam ba? Kita niyo.